But that's right.
The piece that I'm doing is called Ancient Wisdom, and it's in three sections. The first section is inspired by Catherine Dunham. It starts off with traditional Dunham technique progressions that I choreographed into a dance. And the dancers will have the traditional Haitian white skirts and head wraps, and they will be performing sacred movements like the Yanbalu and some of the other Haitian movements that Ms. Dunham researched and brought to the U.S. The second segment is going to be more of a modern influence, which would be the Lester Horton technique, Catherine Dunham, there's Alvin Ailey, there's pretty much every single professor, dance instructor that I've worked with. It has a little bit of everybody. It's an eclectic fusion, Afro-modern fusion technique. But there's also the ballet line, the classic movement that is mixed in there too. The third section is, it's percussion. So we've got that jazz element, we have modern, we have African dance, we even have ballet, and it's a fusion of pretty much all of the dance forms. There may be some acrobatic type movements in there as well. So the main focus of the piece is a timeline of an early modern dance pioneer, which would be Catherine Dunham, and pretty much kind of going, you know, through the years with that timeline, with all the different styles and techniques that I've learned in my career.
Thank you.
by Jules Perrault. The music is by Whitney. It was developed in 1845 originally and was reset by Anton Dolan in 1941. The four original ballerinas were Marie Taglioni, as well as Lucille Grand, Fanny Cherito, and Carlotta Creasy. The costumes are of a very romantic period. They're below the knee, and that was the original tutu. We didn't have the short tutus during that period of time. They were all long because of modesty reasons. I was fortunate enough to be able to do pas de quatre three times in my life, starting from when I was very young, around 13 or 14 years old. I did Marie Taglioni all three times, and the first time it was with Los Angeles Ballet. The second time was with my own company here in Vegas called Bobo's Dance Ensemble. And the third time was with Houston Ballet. All three times I did Marie Taglioni. I know the order that they did their solos because they were all very famous. So the order that they did their solos in was youngest to oldest. So the oldest, which was Marie Taglioni, was last. And that is the cherished position or the coveted position to actually do your solo is last. Usually they have the best dancer go last. So that was always a little bit of a thing between all of the dancers, the four dancers. And it's shown in some of the original pas de quatre versions, when people have restaged it, that when they bow to each other or they look at each other, there's some tongue-in-cheek kind of comedy that goes on. I also think that pas de quatre is probably one of the most historical ballets of the Romantic period. And the Romantic period was, as I mentioned before, back in the 1845, back in the mid-1800s. And pas de quatre really defines that part of the history of ballet. So I think that that is the reason why it should be in this concert. That's the reason why it is a good representation of the history of ballet.